just work hard, and I'm just grateful for everything.
So a lot of people don't know you started as a dancer. Yeah. That was your like introduction. So who are some of the people like you dance for?
So I dance for different artists. I dance for like, I was on tour with Jeremiah for a while. I dance with Meghan Trainor. I dance with Prince. I dance with Miguel. I was in a couple music videos. I dance with Pharrell, Missy Elliott at the BET Awards. Yeah, it was really cool. All right. Dance with Pitbull, like on the X Factor, did a show there.
I'm gonna go back to the Prince thing, but being that you started as a dancer, when was it that you knew that like you wanted to make that transition from being a dancer to now it's my time, like I wanna be an artist?
So when I was in Orlando out here, my parents, they actually owned a restaurant. I don't know if you guys ever heard of it, but it was called Tambora's Grill Cafe. It was like, it was in Winter Garden. Winter Garden Road. But yeah, like, so I used to always do like YouTube covers and stuff in the back of the restaurant. I was super shy with my voice because like I don't have like a crazy belting type of like vocal like range or whatever, but so I thought I wasn't that good or whatever, so I was always shy when it came to my vocals, but I could dance, you know what I mean? So when I moved to LA, I was just really getting like booked and like getting recognized as a dancer. And then from there I kind of just met producers and they're like, you sing? And I was like, yeah. And then kind of got introduced to the studio and then started writing, started playing around with different tracks, and then pretty much started like finding the confidence in my voice and finding like what I could do with my voice, because I found out like it was different. Like I could do a little like rappy type of melody type, and then my falsetto was cool, so I was like, okay, let me play around. Then I found it getting into my bag of that. So I would dance with artists and they all knew I did music as well, but it was paying my bills, you know what I'm saying? It was paying for everything. Anytime I make a quick little check, I'll go shoot a little music video for myself and go put that out. So I was doing everything independently. And at that point, it was just hard to like gain respect just from artists, like, or just from the game in general, because dancing behind some artists, no one's gonna take you serious as an artist yourself, you know? So I was about to go on tour with Meghan Trainor again, and I got hit up by a couple labels at that point, and I was like, dang, like, don't want to leave again on tour for a while and then stop the bad music, or just, so at that point I was like, nah, let me just take these meetings and see what's up. So then from there I met with Epic, with LA Reid, Interscope, and then Def Jam, and I thought, you know, Def Jam was the right home for me, so I was just like, all right, I'm gonna do this. So I really stopped, and yeah, I'm here.
No, that's incredible, especially the journey. Most people don't, and I think I find that a lot, like, especially once you get into the arts, like, you have a passion for it. And most people get stuck in that realm of just being a dancer, but you were able to branch out and actually, like, do what you were passionate about and love. So I think that's dope. At the age of 18, you work with Prince.
Yeah.
Let's talk about it. Mm-hmm. I need all the details.
So he never told me exactly where he found me, but at that moment in my dance career, I was really, like, moving around, doing a lot of different videos here and there. So he told me he found me somewhere online. And I got an email one day saying, Prince, the artist, wants you to do a choreography submission for his new song, Breakfast Can Wait. And so I did a little video of dancing to it, and then after he was like, okay, I want you to write a whole treatment. Here's this amount of money for the video, and I want you to just make it happen. So yeah, my thank God I have my family, they helped me out, and you know, made that happen.
That's at 18, did you even know, like, did you have the resources to even tap into?
Like music video sets, so I was kind of like familiar with the world, but I didn't know how to write a treatment, I didn't know how to be behind the camera, like I didn't know anything like that. So,
and the video actually got released, and it was
that's so dope.
Another legend, you sampled her song, Aretha Franklin. If you don't know, what is it, One Step Ahead, or One Step Ahead? What was the process like to get that cleared and actually like use that as a sample? And also, what did that mean to you, especially because she just recently passed away?
Yeah, you know, I never got to meet her, but I felt like, I thought it was just really cool because, you know, she had to have heard the record to approve it. So that right there was confirmation for me. I was like, okay, you know, because that's a legendary song. Yeah. So it's like, it's her vocals. So she approved it. So that right there was just incredible, like, to have that, you know?
Yeah. When it came to the In My Feelings challenge, you were the first one to do it out of a moving car.
Oh,
when I moved. Right? Then everybody else started damn near dying.
I trying know. To do it. That's so bad.
No, it's not your fault.
I mean, kind of, like, in kind of sense.
I was trying to help you out, but you said
I know. I was like, damn.
No. How did you even come up with that? Like, I wouldn't have thought, because there were so many different creative ways that people did it. But to me, I felt like yours was the most creative. One, I don't know how you went out of breath by the end of that, because you did like a marathon.
Yeah.
But what was the process with coming? How did you, were you just sitting in the car like, I'm going to do it with the car moving?
Yeah, I was with my camera guy, Devon, and we was like, yo, let's do this challenge. I think you'll do good. Like, I think, I was like, okay, let's do it. So we went outside to just go like shoot it in a neighborhood or something. And I told him, I was just like, yo, like, it'd be cool if I'm like moving with it. Yeah, and he just got in the whip. His like leg was over the thing while we played the thing, like driving it, and then I just hopped out, got back in the car, and it just happened like that.
That's
yeah.
talent. Mm-hmm. That's so funny. Okay, so your song, Lil Bebe. Did you write it about anybody?
I mean, you know, I got some inspiration from somebody.
do we know him? Have we?
No.
No.
Nobody knows him.
Do you still talk to him?
No.
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 She said that like, girl, he ain't no good. So there was some inspiration behind it from someone. All right, so tell us the process of like, how'd you come up with that?
So I was in the studio with Ism, he's the producer, and then my friend Jazzy and Vori, they helped me write it. And we were just going through different tracks, different beats. He played that beat, and I was like, oh, that's crazy, like. And he was, I was like, how old are you? He's like, I'm 19. And I was just like, what? I was like, you a little baby. And then Jazzy's like, little baby? And I was like, little baby. And then we just started like playing around, and then the beat was still going on in the background. So then we just kind of started like freestyling, and then got in the booth and just, you know, came up with the song. And we wrote it real quick, and it was just like the one. I felt like, yeah. I don't know. That song was just super genuine. Like, I feel like a lot of my friends naturally like just loved it. Like, you know, you have one song where people are like, oh, this is dope.
Yeah.
That one, like, everybody always bumped to it. And I was like, okay.
Because it's
special.
One of those songs you could just, like, vibe to. Like, yeah. But then it's also a song you can turn up to,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So it goes, like, for...
Mm-hmm. And that's why I really wanted, like, a record for the clubs, you know? Like, a record that you could just go crazy.
Yeah.
Like, really perform to it, so... Yeah.
I was watching the video. How'd you get so many people to do... Like, first of all, let's talk about the concept of the video. I do want to talk about and know how that came about. But how'd you get so many people to do a cameo? Like, everybody was in that video.
Man, that's love. Like, literally, like, people just show love. Because I asked Trey to come through. He was down. I asked a whole bunch of people and then just saw who came up. And I was like, okay, I remember that.
But it was
that's
like
love.
A
Thank
bunch
you.
Of people. Did anyone say no? Because everybody was in there.
I mean, some people... Who was supposed to come and didn't come? Let me think. I don't know, but no, I got a lot of confirmation, so I was like, dang.
Who came up with the concept?
So that sneaker store is called Bodega Sneaker Store, and it's my friend Taisha's like spot, like her friend's spot, whatever. And we went out there just to like look at kicks and stuff, cause it was a dope spot and it's new. And we were just walking around there, and I saw like the place is decorated like a bodega. And I'm Dominican, so I was just like, oh, wow, this is so cool. Like, you don't see nothing like this in Cali. So I was like, yo, we should shoot a video in here. And then they're like, yeah, like, we don't even got to really build nothing out. Because I just kind of wanted a place that, like, I feel like overall the video really represents who I am. Like, I'm a sneakerhead, I'm Dominican, and I really wanted to just showcase my dancing and my personality and just, you know what I mean, in the video. So with that, I think everybody also in the video is like my friends. Like, there's cameos, but then there's other people, like the producer, the writers in there. Like, it's all my people in there, my brother's in there. He was cutting up Trey songs, so. So it was just like, it made sense for everything. And yeah, I just wanted a one-take feel type of video as well. Because I don't like a lot of cuts sometimes in videos. So I thought it would be more... And one-take videos are actually way harder to get. Because it's like, you only got one take to
yeah.
really like capture everything with everything. So, yeah.
Yeah, it seemed very authentic and very, like, it wasn't forced. It seemed like it was a lot of your style. It seemed like it was you. Lil Bebe featuring Lil Bebe. How dope is that?
It's so dope. It's so dope, man. When I first did the record, I actually saved the file as Lil Bebe featuring Lil Bebe.
No.
Mm-hmm.
So you like spoke it into existence.
Yeah.
See, I'm like half speak it into existence, half don't want to jinx it. Like, I go back and forth between those two.
Really?
Yeah, so it's always so hard. So now you're making me lean more to the other side
now.
Speak
it, claim it. You know? Yeah.
So you saved it in your phone as that. Now, how did it actually like come to fruition?
So, sometimes I'll be posting videos on my page of me just like dancing to songs and stuff. And I did one to one a Lil Bebe song. And then I like put in the caption, tag Lil Bebe if you guys want a Lil Bebe remix. Everybody tagged him and he replied and he was like, let's do it. So I was like, let's go. Sent in the DM real quick, like, what's up? So then, you know, my manager too, he hooked it up. We talked to his people and we just made it happen. Like,
speaking of sliding in the DMs, if you,
that's how she heard.
You see where my mind is. This is random too, but speaking of sliding into DMs, if you did have someone slide into your DMs, what would be the proper way you want them to approach you in your DMs?
I mean, honestly, I think it's hard to really like, I mean, I would have to just be interested in the person, I think, like.
Even, okay, so a person you're interested in, because sometimes I've had interest in people, and then they'll just say something, and it's like,
Yeah, I don't know, I guess it's just how the conversation continues, because they could just send an emoji or something, and you'd be like, what's up?
So you down with the what, emoji?
Yeah, like, imagine if they just send, like, a little wave, I'd be like, hi, back. And then what happens after that?
Every man in this room is about to go home.
Send me my wave.
I just want you to know, you just started something.
Damn.
So you dropped your campaign with Foot Locker earlier today.
Yeah.
That is so dope.
Thank you.
And it was so many dope people.
I know.
Meek Mill, a bunch of
people. I was the only girl.
Yeah.
I love being the only girl sometimes. I'm just like, yeah.
What did that mean to you, though?
It was crazy. Like, I got the call that they wanted me a part of it, and I was just like, yeah. They told me DJ Khaled. They told me everybody that was going to be on it, and I was like, wow, like, that's fire. Like, yeah. Let's do it. Like,
you held it down for the females. I was like, yes. Also, there's something dropping at 9 o'clock tonight. Can we talk about it at all?
So it's actually out.
Oh, it's out. Damn.
It's out right now.
Okay,
Blue
let's
Chips,
talk about it.
I just dropped it. Music video's coming on Monday. Yeah, so yeah, I'm happy.
I was
about
on the radio today, and I was like telling people, y'all, like, hit me up if you want me to ask her something. DM got flooded. When is she going to give us Blue Chips? I'm like, yes. I'm pretty sure it's coming tonight, but dang.
Everyone's been asking for it. I've really been like, I've low key, like, put that song out low key, just off of just social media, putting like me performing it or just different clips from the studio and stuff. So everyone's always been asking for it. So I'm like, all right, I'm dropping my album the 30th. So I was like, let me drop that one first. I know people have been waiting for it. So
what can you tell us about the album?
The album is dope. I'm really happy with the album. You know, it's called The Plan. It's just my plan, like, and what I want to do in this world. And, you know, speaking on taking care of my family, speaking on working hard and doing me and being myself. And, you know, love. It talks about relationships, too, that the stuff I've gone through, you know what I mean? And, yeah, it's super. I wanted to show my versatility as an artist in this album. I feel like I got an R&B side to Danny, so you guys will get that. I got, you know, my trap side to Danny too, my turn up side. And then I got my Spanish side too, so I got a full Spanish record with my brother too. So,
yeah. I was going to ask you, being that you are Hispanic, if you planned on incorporating any of that into your music, but
yeah.
I guess so, yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So, any features on the album?
Yeah, so I got a remix coming after with Chris Brown. It's super dope.
What song?
It's called Easy.
Okay.
Yeah. No one knows that, so you guys know which one it is.
Yeah.
That one, and then I got Lil Yachty. Yeah. He killed his verse. I got YBN Amir. Mm. That's my homie. With YG on the same song. It's crazy. And then I got my brother Bills. And then that's it. And then Lil Bebe with the remix, yeah.
Dope. So we can get that on the 30th.
Yeah.
What was the inspiration behind the name of it, The Plan?
The Plan. I mean, just my plan. And you'll hear it in the album and everything that basically I want to do with The Plan. So, yeah.
Dope. So I feel like since you missed all this greatness, dancing,
party.
The party, I think we should have round two, but this time you're going to pick who the winners are.
Oh, okay.
I'll let them pick her. Well, kind of let them pick
don't
her.
Don't be
earlier,
shy
but.
Now.
Yeah, y'all better not be shy now because y'all was in here pop locking, dropping it before. So she in here. Oh, so you don't want to dance now?
He's like, nah.
Where the girl at with the dress who said she had just walked in late? Yeah, you. Uh-huh. I think you. Because everybody else done did their thing. And now they want to act shy. Some people. All right, we need one more person, too. Anybody else who? Oh, okay, he's back. There you go.
He's ready.
You ain't shy? You were shy earlier, but I ain't gonna call you out. Okay. All right, so who's going first? Oh, ladies.
We got Dreads. What's this Dreads squad right here?
Oh, yeah.
Are we going to do the remix or we want to do the original?
Yeah, you can do the remix, that's fine. All right, so I'm letting her pick this up. Go, you need to stretch. We need to give you time. Yeah.
It's a remix, baby. My new baby, baby.
Hey. Because we almost had a round two earlier, so.
It's a remix, baby. My new baby.
Hey.
My new baby.
Hey.
My new baby.
Hey.
Go, baby.
Go.
Change your face down.
Hey.
That's a look through. I'm gonna watch that. Yeah, I'm all
good.
If you won't go.
Hey. It was lit earlier.
Yeah, you guys are fine.
I'm just glad I don't gotta pick it. It's on you.